Like most of us, I've started with playing DBD. Right now I'm having about 2,300 hours, and I mostly played Killer in that time. But when I picked up Gold Express with around 1,900 hours and tried to play Watcher, I got my ass handed to me by this guy, this guy, this guy, and that guy. Especially that guy. Unlike playing Killer in Dead by Daylight, playing Watcher in Gold Express is way harder and way more confusing if you first start off. There's way too much going on. The maps are not as open as in Dead by Daylight. There are way more maps with more than one floor that can be confusing. There are way more objectives on the map than in Dead by Daylight. The camera angle is different. It's third person instead of first person. Most powers are not that easy to pick up. And understanding the energy management is not that easy as well. So in this video I'm trying to teach you how to play Watcher in general and making you better at kicking Extractor's ass. So according to the how to play as Watcher guide from the developers, you first choose a spawning location and land there with your data warehouse. Then you are supposed to patrol the objectives, put viruses on them and hit Extractors whenever you can. Then they go on and say that you're supposed to destroy the data walls around the map to find the extractors easier. And you're supposed to execute knockdown extractors and make them enter the digital form so they lose even more max HP. Lastly, they show that Watchers can prevent extractors from boarding by hitting them under the beam or just staying inside the beam. Well, I can agree to most of what this guide says. There are some important things left out. So I'm going to tell you my opinions of how your first matches should go and what you should exactly do. So for the first match, I would recommend you to pick a killer that you're going to play in the second match as well. Read all the skill and passive descriptions. Or check out my in-depth guide to their Watcher if it is out by that time, so that you can use the first match to prepare yourself and get a good feeling for the power, the movement speed, the attack range and the general feeling for the camera and the map. It is not really important that you get a good result in the first game, just try to get comfortable. I've never seen a new player playing Watcher for the first time and instantly getting a kill in the first match, so don't stress yourself. You are more or less bound to lose in the first match. That doesn't have to be for the second or third match though. Of course, this is really hard since the community is pretty small and most of the players have a lot of experience against more experienced Watchers than you, so just keep that in mind. I will give you a quick list of things that you should focus on your first match. The first and most important thing is how to use your power effectively. Try to think of possible strengths and weaknesses of your character's power. The second most important thing that you should focus on is the objectives. You can see every data warehouse by default, but there are also data mines that you can only see if you hack them. Also, data warehouses that are hacked will be completely red instead of only lined out from the distance. Try to hack as many objectives as you can, so you can keep track of what data warehouse is being worked on right now. This will also give you a nice patrolling route that you can do whenever you don't have anything to do in the match. Next, you should get comfortable with blocking and unblocking data walls. Pressing E on a data wall or on an empty space will build or destroy a data wall. Pressing Q once will build a data wall to about 90%. Pressing Q twice will instantly build a data wall. Try to find out when it is worth it for you to use one or two energy charges on a data wall. Lastly, try to find out what loops are really strong and how you can counter them by either using your power in a correct way or just blocking off the exit paths. So at the beginning of every match, you can choose your spawning location. This is also where you will spawn your personal data warehouse as well. For me, I always try to pick a position closely to the center, so I don't end up with all of the extractors having their data warehouses around the map and making an extremely long patrol route for me. It is not that important that you know every good spawning location as killer, especially not at the beginning, but try to think of one that is easy accessible while patrolling other warehouses, so you waste as less time as possible. So as you can see, the extractors have fortunately built a nice patrol route for me, which I can abuse. So for this match, I chose to ignore the warehouse where Shadow spawned on, because it was only close to my own warehouse. A rule of thumb is that you always want a warehouse to be close to two other warehouses. So that makes my spawning location not optimal, but it made the three other extractors pick a very bad setup that I can play around. So what I do is, after I spawned, I instantly hack my own gen and walk to the closest gen where Godfather spawned. After I hack that warehouse, I instantly walk to the next warehouse and hack that as well. And I do that for the next one as well, so that I have four warehouses hacked and I can see instantly if someone is unhacking one. If I finished my first patrol, I look around to see if anything got unhacked, and if not, I walk to strong tiles and block the good looping parts. Even though hacking is one of my main priorities for the early game, I sometimes interrupt that patrolling to get some easy hits on survivors. It is not worth it to go for long chases in the early game if not every warehouse is hacked yet. With more experience, you will learn to balance between hacking and patrolling and chasing. Now that you have a basic understanding of how to play Watcher, it's time for you to develop your own strategies. Every player in Gold Express has their own way of playing, and every killer plays differently, but I will cover that in a different video. So it's really up to you what you make out of your character. But up to this point, it's down to learning new stuff and repeating it until you mastered it. I can only show you my strategies, but especially I learned this game through a long and rough experience. You can also ask other members of the Discord server for advice on certain killers or on playstyles in general. The last tip I will give you is that you should not look at how many kills you got in the end, but how much max HP the extractors have lost. In my opinion, this shows the true performance of a killer and not the kill count. With that said, there's nothing basic more that I can teach you without going into too much detail. I will put out a video for every extractor and every killer, so if you are interested in maining one of the characters, I will cover that character at some point in the future. With that said, I hope I could help you improve at your game, and I wish you the best at becoming a good Watcher. The next guide will probably come out next week regarding a different topic. See you then.